Hello students, today topic is Sarcoviridae and chicken anemia virus. Sarcoviridae, it's a virus family having single stranded DNA viruses. Earlier chicken anemia virus was also included in a Sarcoviridae family, but now it belongs to a separate family, Anneloviridae family. Sarcoviridae, these are small viruses. Apart from this, parvovirus are also small viruses. And this is also non-enveloped, spherical in outline, icosahedral symmetry, genome is circular, single-stranded, and genome size is 1.7 to 2.3 kilo base pair size. Virion are very stable. And it resists 60 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes, and it can resist a pH range of 3 to 9. And it is known as the smallest viral pathogen. Parvovirus is also small in size, but the parvovirus is having linear genome, and it is somewhat larger in size than the sarcoviridae. So, coming to the transmission route is fecal oral route, means viruses are shed in feces, and ingestion can occur through the oral route. Viral replication is nuclear, and it replicates in actively dividing cells of the tissues of their respective host in the young animals. It is having two genera, sarcovirus and cyclovirus. Earlier also, it was having two genera, which was sarcovirus and gyrovirus. But gyrovirus is removed from this family, and now cyclovirus is added. ICTV, that is the International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, updated Sarcoviridae taxonomy, and the cyclovirus genus was added, and gyrovirus genus was shifted to the family Anneloviridae. In the genus Sarcovirus, important viruses are beak and feather disease virus. Apart from this, other avian sarcoviruses are also present. Porcine sarcovirus 1 and 2 and canine sarcoviruses are present in the genus Sarcovirus. And the type species for the sarcovirus genus is porcine sarcovirus 1. Coming to the cyclovirus, these viruses are isolated from the chicken, goat, sheep, and other farm animals, but their biology and detail is not available. And these are also isolated from the healthy animals' feces and even from the CSF of human beings. Coming to the beak and feather disease virus, it causes debilitating and immunosuppressive disease. And mainly it causes disease in young cetacean world, particularly cockatoos. Cockatoos is a species of parrot, and the disease is known as cetacean beak and feather disease. In this disease, virus shedding occurs in feather dander. Also, fecal shedding of the virus occurs. And in poultry, is a habit of regurgitating crop content. And in the regurgitated crop contents, when virus is present and when it is fed by the chicken, the chicks also gets infected. So feather dander is a dust of the feather, which is just similar to the dandruff. This picture depicts the birds affected with cytisine, beak and feather disease virus. In first picture, you can see the loss of the feathers and also the deformity of the beak. And in second picture, you can see the deformity of the beak. It's a characteristic symptom of the beak and feather disease virus infections. And coming to the clinical findings and the lesions. In this disease, important findings are feather loss, abnormal pin and mature feathers. Pin feathers are the developing feathers and other beak abnormalities. This disease also causes destruction of the thymus and bursa and are responsible for the immunosuppression. This disease can be diagnosed by the presence of intracytoplasmic inclusion bodies in affected feather follicles and which can be seen by electron microscopy. PCR assay can also be done for the diagnosis and for the control of disease. Strict hygienic conditions are required and also screening and the disposal of the infected birds is done to control the disease. Coming to the porcine sarcovirus. Porcine sarcovirus serotype 1 and 2. Porcine sarcovirus 1 is considered as non-pathogenic. It's not significantly associated with disease condition. And the porcine sarcovirus 2, it causes disease in willing piglets at the age of 5 to 18 weeks of the age. And sometimes also in the adults. Infections are subclinical or mild infections. Virus is shed in feces, respiratory secretions, and urine. So the transmission of the disease occurs through the direct contact and through the fomites. What are the fomites? Fomites means any material that carries infections like the clothes, utensils, equipments, and as the virus is shed in the feces and the respiratory secretions, urine, these equipments of the farms gets infected with the viruses and are responsible for the transmission of disease from one pig to another. Porcine sarcoviruses are associated with several disease syndrome and all together these are named as porcine sarcovirus associated disease. As I told you, these are responsible for the many disease syndrome and most important of them is post-weaning multisystemic vesting syndrome. Apart from this, other diseases are this disease syndrome
chala gaya man.
Is it audible?
Yes ma'am.
Apart from post-weaning multisystemic vesting syndrome, this sarcoviruses are also causing dermatitis, nephropathic syndrome, respiratory syndrome, reproductive fat, enteritis, some lesions, and adenitis. This
ma'am.
Is hello, huh?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Huh?
Screen share.
Screen नहीं share ये slide नहीं show कर रहा.
अब slow हो गया.
Porcine sarcoviruses is causing several disease syndrome and one of the most important is post-weaning multisystemic vesting syndrome. Means that different organs, post-weaning pigs are affected and various organs are affected, and it causes wasting syndrome. Means the disease is not causing much, affecting the pigs and causing the wasting syndrome. Means growth parameters are not normal. Apart from this, these are also causing dermatitis, nephropathy syndrome, respiratory diseases, reproductive failures, enteritis, some skin lesions are also causing, and lymphadenitis, means lymph nodes are also affected and causes progressive loss of the weight. It also causes icterus or jaundice-like symptoms, and these disease conditions are exacerbated immunostimulation by the other co-infecting pathogens. Means if the pig is infected with some other pathogens, and it is known that when any infection is there, it causes immune response. Immune response generated by the first pathogen is also enhancing the disease severity of this viral infection, porcine circovirus infection. Disease diagnosis can be done by immunohistochemistry. Immunohistochemistry means it involves the detection of the antigen from the tissues with the help of antibodies. And these antibodies are either enzyme linked, enzyme bond, or having fluorescence bonded to the antibodies, which binds to the antigen and detects them. Other characteristics finding is vitroid inclusion bodies in the virus infected macrophages. Vitroid inclusion bodies means it inclusion bodies are having the shapes of the bunches of grapes. These are the characteristic features in the post-wing multisystemic wasting syndrome of the pigs. Another method for the diagnosis is PCR, and the disease can be controlled by good herd management practices, nutrition, proper nutrition, hygiene maintenance in the farm, and the use of vaccines for the disease control. Coming to the other avian circoviruses, apart from this, many other avian circoviruses are also there and causes infection in pigeons, in canaries, geese, ducks, pigeons, ostrich, etc. And these infections are caused in the young birds and associated with immunosuppression and developmental abnormalities. Next one is the canine circoviruses, and these are not very much significant in the disease condition, but these are found associated with vomition and diarrhea in canines. So the most important disease is the chicken anemia virus. Chicken anemia virus, earlier it was a part of family Cercoviridae, and the genus was gyrovirus, but later ICTV removed this gyrovirus from the Cercoviridae family, and this was included in Anneloviridae family, and the genus was the same, gyrovirus. These viruses are morphologically same as circoviruses, means these are also non-enveloped icosahedral symmetry, but some structural differences are there. These are comparatively larger than the circoviruses and having pentagonal shaped units which are protruding or trumpet shaped. In the above picture, you can see the structure of the capsid of the chicken anemia virus, which belongs to gyrovirus of the Anneloviridae family. And here in the below picture, you can see the circovirus structure. See above picture, protruding pentagonal structures are present, whereas in the below picture, the structure is smooth. Genome is also circular, single-stranded, and it is having negative sense DNA. transmission, it occurs in only in chickens and present in the poultry flock worldwide. Both horizontal and vertical transmission occurs. Vertical transmission occurs through the egg and horizontal transmission through the inhalation or oral exposure. Virus, as the virus is shared in the feces and feather dander, so virus is present in the environment, and through the inhalation or through oral exposure, virus is transmitted to the other chicken. Coming to the, and the virus in a vertical transmission means when the virus is transmitted eggs, it occurs only in the phase of viremic stage. Means that when the poultry is infected, poultry is having viremia, which runs for the approximately 3 to 9 weeks, then only virus is present in the laid eggs. Coming to the pathogenesis and pathology, viremia develops when the birds, even in the single old, one day old chicks are affected, and the virus can be recovered from the most of the organs and the, from the feces for about 3 to 4 weeks. This virus affects mainly the precursor T cells in the thymus and hemocytoblast. Precursor T cells means that the cells which are destined to form T cells, means which will acquire the receptors for the T cells, and hemocytoblast means same cells which forms the blood cells, and these two cells are affected. So what will happen if T cells are affected? It will lead to the immunosuppression, and blood cells are affected, then it will lead to the anemia. So the, as the virus affects the precursor T cells and the hemocytoblast, the main symptoms is immunosuppression and the anemia in this disease. Coming to the clinical symptoms, in chicks, mainly 2 to 4 weeks of the age of the chickens are affected, and disease will be severe if some other immunosuppressive viruses infections are there in the bird, like IBD infection, Max disease virus infections, then disease condition will be more severe. And affected birds will be the depressed, anorectic, and pale. It causes mainly the subclinical infection in the boilers, and only the same symptoms is the loss of weight gain. Mortality may be usually 10%, but it may go up to 50%. And slow recovery occurs in the birds which survive from the acute phase of the disease. In older birds or adult birds, normally no illness is seen, and the loss of egg production is seen. These adult birds are chronically infected or becomes persistently infected, means the virus shed will be occur, and virus will be shed in the through the secretions or the feces, and will infect other birds. Lesions will be seen as the atrophy of the thymus, bursa, bone marrow will be pale, and hemorrhages will be seen under the skin and the skeletal muscles. Blood will be watery, and the slow clotting of the blood will be there due to the thrombocytopenia, means the loss of the, due to the loss of the platelets, the blood clotting will be delayed. This picture shows the symptoms of the hemorrhages under the subcutaneous hemorrhages in the wings. This picture shows the subcutaneous hemorrhages in the skin, and this shows the pale carcass. As the birds become the enemy, the carcass will be pale. Coming to the diagnosis, diagnosis can be done with the help of history, clinical signs, and the pathological finding. But the, for the definitive diagnosis, virus isolation is done in lymphoblastoid T cells or B cell lines. Virus can be isolated in the chicks, one day old chicks also. And virus antigen can be detected by immunohistochemistry in the tissues. For antibody detection, ELISA, indirect immunofluorescence, or virus neutralization test can be used. Indirect immunofluorescence means the two antibodies will be used. Primary antibodies will not be tagged with the fluorescence, but the secondary antibodies will be tagged with the fluorescence, and it will be anti-antibodies which will bind to the antibodies attached to the tissue and will detect the infection. Another method is the PCR. PCR can be used for the detection of the viral genome. Coming to the immunity, prevention and control, maternal antibodies and the controlled exposure are the main method for the control of the disease in the boilers. Apart from this, good managemental practices in the farm and hygiene are required to the control the diseases. As this disease gets aggravated by the presence of other immunosuppressive viruses, so it is better to control other immunosuppressive viruses to prevent the additive effect of the disease. And in some countries, vaccination is also practiced for the control of disease. So thank you. This concludes the this disease. And in nutshell, you in chicken anemia virus, it belongs to Annelobiridae family. Genus is gyrovirus. It causes immunosuppressive disease, anemia, and the characteristic symptoms and the lesions are anemia and immunosuppression, low growth in the boiler birds, and the lesions will be in the destruction of the or atrophy of the thymus and bursa, pale bone marrow, and hemorrhages under the skin. And the blood clotting will be delayed, and inclusion bodies will be identified, and the virus can be isolated in the cell lines. And so for the control, managemental practices, control or other diseases are important. So this concludes the disease, chicken anemia.